So I wanted to show you here our blooms so that you can see we are getting ready to have an amazing show. This entire rose bush is budded out. Let's head down here. You see all these babies. I'll keep going. Look at that. One little one down here. And then I'll take you down just a little bit further. And that is Amour de Moline. I just did a quick snapshot of that one. She's looking amazing. And then look at this. This one is Vanessa Bell. Do you see all of these blooms? I mean, this is just spectacular. I can see all the buds all the way down to the water. We are waiting for our blooms and it is so thrilling. And so I just shared with you how amazing they're looking. So while we're waiting for them to bloom, this is kind of like a PSA. I've got to get this out because I have been affected by it in the past, and it's so disheartening while you're watching for these blooms and waiting, and then you come out one morning and they're gone. And you think, what in the world happened? Now, city folks, this doesn't apply to you. This is for the country. And for us, we struggle with deer, rabbit. Who knows what kind of vermin are coming in the middle of the night and dining on our beautiful blooms. So I wanted to share with you what I do. I don't want to scare all of my newbies that there's so much to think about because we've got fertilizing and you're going to do that once a month. And then when you go out and look and you see that you've got aphids, you can treat those if you want. And so now we've got one more thing to think about, and that's the deer. When we get to this point where I've got buds on the roses, is that's when I know that it's time to go ahead and spray. And so what I spray with is organic, of course. And so that is Bobex. And I have tried other things. They don't work as well. I'm gonna go ahead and link this down below. And it even says on it that it is the best as tested by Connecticut Department of Forestry and Horticulture. It has whole egg solids, cloves, garlic oil, water, vinegar, fish meal, cat food, urea, magnesium sulfate, wintergreen oil, fish oil, and sodium benzoate. I don't know what that is. If you've used the Alaska fish oil to fertilize, then you'll be okay with this. But if you haven't, just prepare yourself that it is very potent with its smell. And so I typically try to do it on a day when the wind is moving it away from my neighbors, or first thing in the morning before the walkers go by. So they'll just say, wonder what that is today, something off the river. But it is pretty potent stuff. The next day it won't be as bad. Sorry, the wind is getting me. I spray this on all of my buds, and I know you're asking right now, does that make it lose the scent that I'm going to have when the bud finally opens? No, not for me. What I have found is that it just coats the outer of the rosebud itself so that when it opens, you don't smell that outer, and it's going to diminish over a couple of days. It says that you're going to do this every 10 to 14 days during spring and summer, but this is a year-round treatment. I use this not only during the spring and summer, and I use it on anything that's blooming. I've lost hydrangeas where I'm like, man, this, you know, limelight's looking so beautiful and it's getting ready to pop, and I come out in the morning, bud gone. And I'm gonna do this today on all of the rosebuds that are getting ready to go, all of my hydrangea blooms. I do the abrevieties only during the winter because the deer get so hungry that they are eating anything that they can, and they will devour the bottom of an abrevitae from their height down to the ground, and it takes forever to grow back. I treat with the Bobex during these heavy times. I do it once a week, and it says on here that you don't need to do that, and during the fall and winter do it every 4 to 8 weeks. But you know what, I'm not taking any chances. We've got some really hungry deer, and I love all of God's creatures, you know that, but I want them to go love somebody else's yard, not mine. So I'm a big fan of Bobex. Okay, and so then you want to make sure that you do this a couple of hours before it rains. So it says at least 6 hours for it to dry before rain. But then you'll have that peace of mind that you've done everything that you can to save your blooms. And if you've got rabbit problems, use it on those plants that are down low. The Bobex also has a rabbit formula and different formulas for different things. And OPS, it also takes care of elk and moose, and including deer. So if you've got elk or moose, this is your product. If you got rabbits, go ahead and use it on that too, because they don't like the Bobex. This is already mixed up, so you don't have to mix it. Just go ahead and put it into your sprayer and then spray liberally on your plants. The other option I want to share with you that's organic is this here, the Critter Ritter. And so what is that? This is something that you're going to plug into your hose and then put it in front of your plants. My mom uses these for daylilies because she loves her daylilies, and the deer always come and nibble on them in the middle of the night. So this was her solution that she liked, was that she hooks this up, and when it senses motion, it's going to spray really quick with a spray of water. It will deter whatever animals that you have that are near your plants. So you can use this, of course, roses or anything else where you've got a problem with animals. And so what she does, and I do, is I put it on a timer so that it only comes on after the sunset, because I don't want to be out there gardening and then begin hit by a spray of this every single time I walk by. So if you set it to come on just during those evening hours or while you're asleep and you can't watch it, this will take care of your problem too. And what I just want to add with deer, what I have found is that, so if you can see here, they come across the waterfront here as well as the roadside. And so this is just a nice little walkthrough, and they're looking for a buffet. And so if you can break that cycle for a deer where, you know, they're not thinking, hey, this is a great place to feed and let me go ahead and call all my friends over too and let's meander. They don't come into my property even though I have a lot of plants and something fun to nibble on. They really just go across the waterfront side and the street side. And so you want to break that cycle of them thinking that that your place is a fun place to eat. And so as you are treating, you won't have to treat as heavy as you go through the season, because they'll realize that this isn't where they want to eat. Give it a try. Let me know what else you use, maybe that I haven't tried before. I really like organic solutions, and I'm hoping that this will work for you and it'll save your blooms through the season. Till next time.